Alright, so welcome back to the beginning of my Death Mode throwing playthrough. This is technically Death Mode Season 3, just that I'm gonna be focusing on the throwing class in this playthrough. Plus, I wanted to make it a bit harder, so I removed a lot of mods that would help me. For example, I do not have Fargus mod anymore. I do not have Alchemist NPC, which is by far the biggest change. And I also don't have Weapon Mode, even though that didn't help. The animation got kind of boring, because I've been using it for months now. So I just basically went without it. My goal was to just make the mod pack as small as possible, but while still keeping essential mods. So this will be a really challenging playthrough, and I can see myself getting stuck on some bosses even. So I'm interested to see how this goes. Now I'm gonna be staying completely zoomed out, because I wanna actually go tryhards even though I'm gonna be making throwing weapons. So my problem right at the beginning, we can't even deal damage, because I'm gonna try to go full throwing, which means I will only deal damage, or like pure throwing, which means I will only deal damage if I actually have a throwing weapon. So I'm hoping to find some like shuriken in there. Like I said, I'm gonna be trying to keep it only throwing damage as much as I can. And while we're at it, I might as well just go and enable Revengeance already. No throwing weapon yet. So my first goal when it comes to throwing weapon is to either get a lot of like throwing knives, or like Wolfram throwing knives, or maybe... Okay, this is amazing. I'm gonna have to keep 50, because I wanna go for the crystalline, which I showed in my last playthrough. That's actually a really good throwing weapon for the beginning, and it's kind of hard and annoying to get. But it's gonna be worth it if I get it in the end. Wooden boomerang. This is melee, so I can't use it. The thing is, with not having Fargus mod, there's a lot of weapons that I can't turn into throwing alternatives. So I might just install Fargus after this episode. Because as far as I know, Enchanted Boomerang, for example, is also considered a melee weapon. And Fargo would allow me to turn it into a throwing weapon. I'm not even sure about that anymore, to be honest. Also, my good old Vein Miner's back. Just for like convenience sake. I mean, it doesn't really help, it just makes things a lot easier and less annoying. It's not like Alchemist NPC that makes boss fights easier. Now, one thing I wanted to talk about right at the beginning, because this is gonna be sort of a slow beginning. Oh, for fuck's sake, no. Oh, jeez. In the last episode, I talked about bringing other games to this channel, and I got a surprising amount of really positive feedback. I wasn't expecting it. And that actually made me reconsider it, and I really want to start a different game on this channel now, next to Terraria. And I will most likely do that in the near future, not now because I really don't feel like it at the moment. But when I start, and when I actually do it, I'm not gonna be starting with Dark Souls 3, like I said. I'm actually gonna be starting with Cuphead. Reason being, Cuphead, like if I jump from Terraria to Dark Souls, that's gonna be a weird transition, more or less. Okay, how do I get out of this? Like, it's two different games completely. And if I go from Terraria to Cuphead, that's at least somewhat the same genre. I mean... Okay, not really, but you get what I'm trying to say, right? It's not gonna be such an insane jump from one game to another. Okay, so this works. He also dropped the javelins, which we can use now. This is going to be an insanely challenging playthrough if I'm only gonna be going throwing damage. And I might... I have to say this right at the beginning, I might fuck up at some point. Like by accidentally using a weapon that is melee instead of throwing. Since I'm not used to this, so I don't know which weapons are melee, which ones are throwing. I'm gonna have to take a look, but eventually I will fuck up. Though obviously, like, I'm gonna try my hardest to not fuck up in a boss fight, since that's gonna or would be pretty retarded. But as far as weapon goes, I think besides Wolfram knives and the crystalline at the beginning, there's not much we can really do. So like, I guess I'm gonna have to go vanilla for the first couple bosses, since getting the crystalline, if you remember, it's gonna be a pain in the ass. Also, I really want to take a different path. Okay, I guess I'm just gonna dig down at this point. So like, let me show you the recipe for the... Never mind, I'm getting chased. So the recipe for the crystalline, if in case you forgot, because it's been quite a while. For the crystalline, you need to get 50 throwing knives, which we have at this point. 5 diamonds, which is going to be a pain in the ass, like the hardest thing, and 3 fallen stars, which is like shouldn't be too hard. But like getting 5 diamonds is gonna be really painful and completely luck-based. Wait. Oh, for fuck's sake, are you kidding me? And yes, of course, at the beginning we are not even in death mode, because we have to find a demon altar. I'm still not a big fan of like having to go to a demon altar to craft it, because if I want to play a difficulty, I want to enable it as soon as I can. But I mean, that's a game, so I guess I'm just gonna have to get used to it and find a demon altar. Now, before I go down there again, because I didn't really see any purpose in going further down, I'm just gonna try something different. Like, with something different, I mean going into this direction and maybe finding something. Also, we can get some more throwing, like Wolfram throwing knives. I wish there should be more weapons that are infinite at the beginning when it comes to throwing, I feel like. Also, one of the most important things with this playthrough, this is basically going to be like a test run of throwing. So when I discover that a certain part of the game really doesn't work as throwing, which for example I'm pretty sure Yaron will not work, then I can actually like go and sort of report this and maybe we get a throwing weapon or like something new in order to fill that gap, maybe we get a buff. So this is basically like a testing run, the same I did for Summoner, just as a complete playthrough. So if I get stuck on something, then I might just have to wait for like a test version and then we might get something buffed. So yeah, that's like... I do expect a lot of holds in like the playthrough when it comes to how good we can progress. So we can go ahead and enable death mod over here, which might or might not be a good thing. I mean, I was complaining about not being able to make enable it earlier, so I'm just gonna be enabling it as soon as I can, which is now. But that might not really be a good idea. Anyways, let's go. Death mod is activated. I'm not gonna go down here, because now the death mod is active, most of those things will one-hit me. Which means I will just go ahead and actually continue. Now, in case you don't know, without Alchemist NPC, it's gonna be complete torture, because I'm not gonna be able to buy potions before boss fight. I'm actually gonna have to farm them. Which means I have to make a potion farm. I mean, in post-Moonlord Calamity, you can easily farm that stuff, but like, getting Zerg potions is gonna be really hard. Getting Zen potions is gonna be even harder, because we need to kill pink slimes for a Zen potion. So you get my point, right? It just felt like using Alchemist NPC feels like you're abusing something in Calamity that is not supposed to happen. Like, you shouldn't be supposed to have a Zen potion basically any time. So I feel like by not using Alchemist it's gonna be way harder, but I'm also gonna be getting like the more pure Calamity experience, if you know what I mean. And I'm gonna be trying my hardest to stick with this throughout the entire playthrough. But maybe if this becomes too brutal and I realize I'm not having any fun, then I might change it. But then again, I know I hit all bosses in death modes as a summoner, so there's nothing that is not fun for me, I believe. Alright, so hopefully we find a flying carpet in here. Clouds in a bottle, I can't complain. I'm actually gonna go down here, since I have the feeling I might find something. Plus it's turning night, so going outside wouldn't be a good idea at all. Alright, so I'm gonna have to be careful here. Once I see an enemy, I'm most likely just gonna recall out. Also, it would be nice if we could find a magic mirror in this playthrough. Not like the last one, where I fucking finished an entire death mode playthrough without a single magic mirror. That was just the meme at this point. Okay, I'm gonna have to get out of here. This worm would legit one-hit me. So I'm gonna go to the left and see if I can find something here. I don't have high expectations though. I feel like the beginning is just gonna consist of me trying to find Shuriken and all of that. Actually, I'm kind of stupid. I can just build an NPC house, then let the merchant move in, and then with the merchant I can go and buy Shuriken and all of that. I mean, I might as well use this as a house for now. See, my plan of this playthrough is I wanna go ahead and build a house in the desert, or like a desert city, which would look pretty amazing with this desert, now that I look at it. So that's going to be my goal, because I never built inside of the desert. But like for the beginning, just as a temporary house, I can just go ahead and use the houses here. Shouldn't be too much of a problem. Oh, okay, so we found a lot of sapphires, but sadly no diamonds yet. Finding diamonds would literally be the best thing that could happen at this point, because then I can make the crystalline. And we all know the crystalline was good enough to kill the Eye of Cthulhu. So like, would be amazing. Anyways. Also, I think you can tell that I'm pretty hyped for this playthrough. At least I feel like you can. So yeah, what I'm gonna do definitely after this night has ended is I'm gonna teleport back home and then build NPC houses so that that I can get the merchant inside. Because from the merchant I can buy throwing knives and all, and that's like the only way of dealing damage at the moment until we find diamonds. Plus I should be able to craft quite a lot of those, like the throwing knives at this point. You can craft 50 out of 1. So yeah, we could make a lot of those. We need an anvil though. which we do not have currently. We found a couple emeralds, which also can't hurt. I mean, we are going to need a lot of gems since we can't buy them. And we are going to need them for magic storage. Also, I have two of them. Yeah, my bad, I could have deleted them a long time ago. And we get a magic mirror. Someone in the comments actually said that we are going to get a magic mirror in the first episode. And hey, we did. This is a fucking joke, man. It's hurting my feelings. While I'm down here, I have the feeling that I might be able to already craft an entire tungsten armor set. Since we, like, bars alone, we have 40 already. And we have like 100 ore. So this might be something. I'm definitely gonna be trying this. So let's go and make a furnace and see how many bars we can get out of this. A total of 67. I know for a fact this is not gonna be enough, sadly. But I'm gonna make an anvil nonetheless, because this means we can make the... Where is it again? Wolfram throwing knives. Here. Because I'm gonna need them for now. 400 should... Yeah, this should be sufficient enough for the beginning. Then while we're at it, might as well just make a tungsten pickaxe. And the tungsten axe so I can farm wood easier. Anything else I could make at this point? This is a thing? 75%. This is actually better, so... Okay, I'm gonna make this. I didn't know this is a thing. This is a pretty good axe, from the looks of it at least. And then I'm also gonna make the platinum bars to get some space. Alright, so far so good. Tungsten armor, exactly. How much can we make? We can make the breastplate at least for now. I'm gonna be going for wolfram armor again, once I get enough. But obviously I need some kind of weapons first before I can actually take them on. Also, I need to make some space in my inventory now. Let's just drink this, whatever. Also, one of the best things about the Wolfram knife is that I can actually just hold it, I don't need to click anymore. Also, I got a suggestion that is something that I'm actually gonna be doing from now. Every time I have like an insanely boring farming session, I'm just gonna speed it up and then like turn the sound off and I'm gonna talk over it as like a post commentary. So if I have anything to announce, if I have anything to talk about, I'm just gonna be using the farming sections to do that. Which means it's going to be, like, I need to put more work in, obviously. But then again, my videos, like, my playthroughs get the most amount of views. Almost 5 or 6k on average. So if I announce anything inside this episode, then it's gonna be the best thing, basically. Also, the skeleton merchant, I think he sells some throwing weapons, so I'm gonna try to get over there. Well, yeah, I expected them to split. I still fucked up. I'm gonna try to get back down there because I want my money back, even though most of it is gone already. It's actually not too hard to get down there, and then after that I'm gonna go and build the NPC house. Never mind, I don't even have to because they're gonna move in those houses now. And since we have the merchant, I can go and buy some shuriken. And then continue my exploration down there. I'm not gonna lie, it's literally... Like, it is so perfect that we get a magic mirror in the first episode. I could not have... I really wanted this to happen, honestly. But hey, at least we can go and make the sapphire hook. And I'm gonna try to get back down there because that cave looked promising. Even though, like, what I should really be doing is build NPC houses at this point. You know, death mode is amazing for bosses and all, but if you have to do an actual playthrough in death mode, then it's kind like it's kind of taking the fun away because of how much damage everything does. And early game is just way too crazy. But like, then again, that's what you're signing up for if you're going death mode, to be honest. The thing is, I believe we can't even get any kind of throwing weapon out of the golden chests. Since the, like, boomerangs are all melee. So, I don't know, man. It's kinda useless to farm here. All I need is just diamonds. But still, like, having a spelunker potion would speed things a lot up a lot. So, that's one of the things I'm really trying to get right now. Oh yeah, and one more thing I wanted to address again, because I'm not sure if everyone like realized it. I talked about it in my final episode from my last playthrough, but in this playthrough I'm gonna be actually uploading less often. So like only every third to fourth day. But whenever I upload, I will go ahead and make like a longer episode, so like 30 minutes or something. Or at least I'm gonna try. It's not guaranteed. But I just feel like I don't want my videos to become repetitive by uploading daily. That's something a subscriber told me, I thought about it, and it's actually a really good advice, so I'm not gonna be, or like, trying to stay away from that, I mean. You know, there's another thing that might work, and I don't know, it sounds kind of stupid, but it might be a good idea. Only uploading once a week, but then uploading for, like, an hour-long episode. That would be... I mean, it would be pretty good for me. It would... Well, my videos wouldn't be repetitive. And you guys would be really hyped for my videos, so... Like, in case you want to see one episode weekly, but then, like, another episode, then let me know. That would actually be pretty good, but then again, I will definitely have days where I feel like I want to play more than just an hour. So I don't know how that's gonna work out, but the idea is definitely not too bad. Okay, so attempt number three. Traveling merchant arrived. I definitely need to check him out in a bit. I just wanna see if I can get a chest down here, maybe. I mean, I already heard the door, so there's definitely one of the houses over there. Are you kidding me? Harpies? I guess there's a harpy statue? Oh no, they can get out. This is really bad. Are you fucking kidding me? A harpy statue? Really? Alright, so here we are once again. Please don't kill me. I mean, I don't even know what I'm expecting from the chest. Like I said, there's no, as far as I know, no throwing weapons inside of there. But hey, at least we got here. And hammer's boots. Alright, this was definitely worth it then. Or the pain. But I need to get rid of the statue. I don't want to anymore to spawn. Like harpies at this point, I really don't want to deal with them. Okay, so the die trader decided to go up here for some reason. Reflective obsidian die. I'm just gonna be putting my die on for now because we don't have anything anyways. Okay, this looks pretty shit. Anyway, I'm just gonna keep it. So, judging by this, yeah, it's still just diamonds. So, I don't know, man. Do we have any bombs, maybe? Bombs or grenades? No, we don't. Alright, so we found the dungeon. Might as well just break the pots. I'm not gonna go any deeper. Because I have the feeling this seems like a really low dungeon. Even though... Okay, technically it isn't, but I'm just scared to go down deeper. Which means I'm not gonna do that. Dying now would mean I have to go the entire way back. But this looks amazing. This is a pretty cool dungeon. Because it's inside of the mountain. But since I built a dungeon base in my last playthrough, I'm not gonna be building another one. So there's technically zero reason to go down here. I'm still gonna do it because if we get an Akalis or something, I might be able to sell it. And then buy like Shuriken or something out of it. And it's a wooden sword. I mean, maybe we can find a cave entrance close to this. Would be at least somewhat useful then. Nope, none here and none here. Alright, let's go back up. Oh, you're right, now that I think about it, the Abyss, or like the Sulfuric Sea, has the sea urchins. And they drop their stingers, and those are pretty good throwing weapons for the beginning. So that might be good enough already. And they drop it at any time, that's like the amazing part about it. I just have to be careful because they do a shit ton of damage. There we go, there's one of them. Alright, so 400 HP and they do 160. I kind of underestimated them, not gonna lie. Alright, next try. Please, I don't want any, like, Mother Slam or something. Oh, I see something really amazing. I don't know if you guys saw it, but I saw it. Also, there's a granite bomb here. I'm gonna stay away from the granite bomb for now. I think you can imagine why. What I want to do is I want to just build myself in and start to dig down, because I saw a mushroom shrine. Now, the loot of the mushroom shrine will be completely useless to us, I believe. Since, well, we are throwing and I think it's a summoner accessory. Also, it's inside of a spider cave, which doesn't make anything... Oh god, it's gonna be hard to get. But hey, finding a shrine, even if it's an item that isn't, like, of use for you, it's still an amazing feeling because of how rare they are. I mean, you literally only get one per word. Or like one of each type, so 9 in total. Okay, so we are getting this. Yeah, this is obviously a summon accessory, so whatever. But still. It's a great feeling to get the shrine because of how rare it is, so I don't really care. Plus, we might be able to sell this for quite a lot of money. Since I feel like selling a post-Plantera accessory in pre-hard mod should give a lot of money. At least I'm hoping. Alright, so I'm just gonna put away all of the loot I got. And like the fact that we are not finding diamonds is kind of disappointing at this point. I think I'm just gonna end the episode here and then get the crystalline next episode. I wanna try to make this playthrough way longer. I mean, you might already see that I'm taking things way slower. I'm gonna check real quick how long I'm recording because I have no idea at this point. The thing with this playthrough is I won't even need to try to slow things down because throwing is gonna be so hard that things are slowed down anyways. But hey, enough talking. I hope you enjoyed the episode. See you in a couple of days and goodbye.